was a tiny one, and he built it so big. So he modified it, made it big.
Well, they did beautiful finish work.
Thank you.
Yeah. I know that takes a...
That's the hard part of
it. I know. I know. That's where a lot of the time went.
That, you get it polished, and then you're trying to put it together without getting fingerprints and everything on it. It's the hardest part of making the whole thing.
Yep. Making it look right is... more difficult. Now here's George Brinell. Here's another guy that can do some stuff. George Brinell. Here's a miniature Corliss. And again, this thing is only about 6 inches long. Look at that. Here's another beautiful piece. This is all the work of George Brinell. Hi, George. How are you doing?
Thank you.
Good, good. This is a great little engine. It's very similar to a domestic hopper-cooled engine with a side shaft. Beautiful little piece. And here's a couple more little hit and misses. Now here's the little hop and puff engine. Vertical and horizontal version. And these are really small. See that? These are tiny. Good morning, Joe.
Good morning. Yo.
Welcome to Southgate.
Oh, thank you very much.
All of my engines.
Got to do that again. Good morning, George.
Good morning.
Nice to see you.
Yeah, I...
Now, here's a hit-and-miss engine from China. Got ball bearings. Charlie opening up a box delivered by Bruce. Good morning, Bruce. Nice to see you.
Hi, Gil.
Thanks for bringing this. I was wanting to see it up close. All right, guys. Now, before you go any further, look underneath the base. Empire Giant Strides Wing number 4BR, made especially by St. Paul's Steam for Nick. Wow. Congratulations, Nick. Yeah, that'll put a smile on your face. And this one, made by St. Paul Steam, the Empire Giant Stride Swing for Charlie Miller. Congratulations, Charlie.
Thank you.
Great piece. Very well done. Yeah, Bruce. Beautiful. On what? What did he do that on?
He took the ball down, he took the pulse in the way.
Up here?
Have a good day.
Yeah, he took the ball down and it caused the pulse in the way.
Oh, because it was...
flexing.
Yeah.
Gil's video in two.
Yep. Here's our friend Charlie, the Texas lab man.
Howdy.
Yeah, yeah. Making a film. One that's shaped less than mine. Here's a really nice custom-built Jensen 55G by St. Paul Steam.
That's it.
Love that noise. Thanks, Ron. Excuse me, sir. Thank you very much. Here's Cliff's Lambs Bulldog. Hey, Cliff. Great to see you here today.
Hey, yeah, good to see you, Gil.
Here's a nice Hulk display, which actually can do something. Yeah. And here's a Nash.
I got to tell you about this, Gil. This is my first engine.
Right?
1971.
1971, right here.
I built this one in 2018. It's powering this air compressor to this tank, which will run that engine.
There you go. All right. You feel like firing it up?
Well, we can try.
Sign me up. Oh, that is sweet. Oh, you remember what shelf you tucked it under or over? That's a great model. And if this looks familiar to some of you, this is about double the size of the regular Nash. About double? How much bigger is this than the other model?
The original is 316.
316, so it's 50% bigger. 50% bigger. Yeah.
Maybe about a new time or so, you can start them up again. Get old.
Oh, look at that.
So, if you would, please.
This is what I'm working on right now. This is
the
basic. Yeah. I recognize this from Doug Kelly's work and Jeff Connor and those guys.
Yeah, Doug gave me the plan for this.
Yeah, nice, nice. And you expanded this one.
I run across this at a rummage sale. It's a telephone.
Right. Radio. Yeah.
And it was in such fine shape, I decided I'd put it on there just for show.
Why not? That's great.
It isn't much good for anything else.
Now, are these a little impeller pump?
No, they're gear pumps.
They're gear pumps. Okay.
Yeah,
that's why it's tall. All right.
The gear pumps are so much more positive than you
feel. Yeah, they're much more efficiency. Well, Cliff sure brought a nice display this year. Here's his Williamson. Here's the sliding cylinder engine. You see the whole cylinder moves up and down. How are you? Here's the Musgrave steam engine. And here's Hero's Ball. And here's the McConey's Oscillator. And the Stothard and Pitt beam engine. Here's the Red Devil, here's the Quincy, one-tenth scale of the Cavanaugh and Darley Red Devil. I believe they were in Chicago. There's a woodpecker right there. Here's a little John Deere. And here's a mogul. Spring pool mogul. That's neat. This is a side shaft engine, as you can see. And here's a ball monitor with a pump. Here's a topsy-turvy. A Red Wing, a V-Bolt Blonde, and that looks like, hi, how are you? And that looks like a McCormick Deering. Here's an International.
I call this the McCormick Deering.
What's that?
I call it a McCormick Deering.
They do.
Yeah.
No, it's an International.
I used to call them a four-horse International. That's a mogul over there.
Yes,
that's your mogul.
Yep.
It sort of runs.
Okay. Very nice. Nice cart, too. Sub chaser.
So do you have to clean those?
And here's the PM research.
If they're going across, do they get all...
Oh, they just keep the shaft polished. The machine companies used to give them away when they bought the machine. And they were just cardboard rails.
You talking about these rings?
Yeah.
Keep it clean. Just wrong. This is all part of the PM research display. Nice to see you here again.
Nice to see you, Gil.
All right. They asked us to stop the gas engines, right? That's all right.
I lose my display, but I got a air one
here. Are you going to be here tomorrow?
Yeah.
I'll try to swing by in the morning.
Okay.
Yeah, that's pretty. Beautiful. Thank you.
Thank you.
There's a little one. Yeah, it is. Yeah, a little table saw you made with it.
You use that thing a lot.
Oh, yeah. It's good for cutting French fries.
Yeah.
And whatever else you stick in it. And fingers. Yeah.
But it's also good for cutting bolts.
I'll bet it is.
And I ripped this saw blade to width from it.
Okay.
Right over there, lady.
Oh, that's on it?
Well, that's the magazine. Okay. I don't know if they've got them in stock.
Yeah.
They get it on air. This is to heat it.
Okay.
So it doesn't freeze up.
That keeps it a little bit just warm enough to keep it fluid. So it's made very accurately.
Yeah.
Another beautiful engine. Work of Jerry Pontius. Here's another one of my favorites. This one right here, a beautiful little windshield wiper style engine. And here's another one right here. A wiper-style engine. Well, Jerry, it's great seeing you again
here. Good to see you, yeah.
I still